Florida.
Bounce back.
Okay, senor. Scooting and booting right along to Mr. Senor Hunter. What was yours?
You know, I was just like trying to think there while Sam was like talking. Halloween hasn't always been like the holiday that I always trying to celebrate and whatnot. For any particular reason. But remember whenever I was a kid, I had this infatuation with like ninjas. So, and also whenever I was a little kid, I was also really short and also really fat. So I was pretty much just like a little short, fat kid running around in some ninja spandex throughout the neighborhood looking for all the houses with like the big chocolate bars.
Where's the big ones?
Was really good at that, you know, really enjoyed it, really honed my skills. So I would just think like the biggest spooky, best like crazy costume would definitely be the little fat.
The ninja.
Ninja boy, you know?
Love that.
Senor, was I a ninja with you once? I feel like
Senor,
you,
of course. It was our fat days.
Oh, yeah.
Senor, ninja, oh, senor. I think I was the blue one, the Sub-Zero, and you were the yellow one. I think there's some like pictures.
There's definitely pictures.
Can we get a cheers to pictures. Peter Hamm and Hunter Graham's glow up over the years. I mean, you guys really turned into a couple of
Oh, smolders. We turned it around. All you fat, young kids out there, don't worry. You'll be just fine.
We'll cheers that.
Don't give up hope.
We'll cheers that.
Look at these fine.
My brother, Christopher Hamm, shout out Chris, was a candy corn addict.
Yeah.
Addicted.
Cham Classic. Needs to see me on the golf course, by the way.
Ooh.
Is this a challenge? We got a challenge.
See me,
give him a message.
On the
let
course.
Him know. Here,
give it to him, Cham. Let him know.
I just had to let him know.
Is that it?
That's all I got. That's all I got.
Okay. Where do you want to chat? What course?
I'll fly down to Puerto Rico.
Ooh.
Course. I'll play him at his home course.
Ooh.
Show him who's daddy.
Wow.
Ooh, love to see it.
Sounds
love
like some big money's going to be thrown around on the golf course, boys.
Just money.
I
want to
play him for that.
Like an hour from Abilene and whatnot, but was driving down this like spooky road.
Spooky
road.
Season.
Ridiculous. And I have an older brother, an older sister. They decided to put on the movie Jeepers Creepers. And the setting of that movie is literally like in the exact same place of where we're like driving down. And so like I'm little, I'm probably like 4 or 5. And they're just saying like Jeepers Creepers. Ugh. And it's like creeping the living shit out of me. And so ever since then, just not a scary movie guy. You know, like looking back at it,
soft.
I really have no rationale, reason, whim, or why. You know, I just have kind of put my foot in the ground, kind of like at the Alamo when Travis drew that line. And the line was no more scary like movies.
That's respect.
Hunter Graham, you know.
That's respect.
Yeah,
Senor, just a piggyback.
Yeah,
off
give
that,
it to me.
I distinctly remember that chapter of our life where you were just you scared shitless. Anyone said Jeepers Creepers?
Absolutely.
You'd be like, stop.
Absolutely.
Cut it out.
I actually remember that too.
Tired of that shit.
I remember you telling me about that,
which I fully understood because I also went through a phase.
Senor,
and
CC.
I'll tell my movie. My or movie, real quick.
It's going to be that
the
one.
The Ring.
I was there.
Ooh.
I was present for
ooh.
For this.
Hunter was there for this.
Remember, like, is that was at my house.
This is Hunter's 9th birthday. I'll never forget it, dude. It's
we
like
rolled.
A scar in my head. And
literally, I remember
we were
it like
in
it was
Ashley Graham's room. Senor, no candy eating
okay,
this weekend.
Okay.
I
yeah,
ate
respect this.
I ate buffalo wings like I do on a regular basis, which I gotta get off. Which I gotta get off.
Those some Sonic buffalo wings or what?
You will always be eating the buffalo wings.
Is anyone else out there who's listening? good to see you if you listen. Anyone else out there have a buffalo wing problem? Not problem, just a strong liking. I don't know. What would you call it?
I would even say like a love.
And I don't like that at all. I like positive vibes. I like funny movies. I like action movies where, like, you know, you have a hero. I'm an old school, right. Like,
yeah, same.
That type
Starsky
of thing.
And Hutch.
Exactly.
Unbelievable stories.
The best.
It's hilarious.
Great vibes.
It's electric.
Groovy like a dragon.
Good vibes and good stories. Taking you over the downloads.
Unforgettable. It is everything.
It's just a grand, good old time.
My go-to podcast. The Hamm Planet
Podcast. Hamm Planet Podcast, number one.
Why the f*** not?
We're happy to see ya.
Yeah, I feel really good right now.
I can say this to you kids.
I was born ready.
Okay. Bet. Game on. Game on.
If you don't scrape your tongue, you're nasty.
Remember the Alamo.
He is.
So let's give it up, ladies and gents.
Wow.
I pop my perk over taunted.
How are the women in Green Bay, Wisconsin?
How are the women in Green Bay?
Need to get on his yoga regimen.
Em needs to see me on the golf course, by the way.
Ooh.
I am Fiona in the swamp.
To me? I'm talking to you.
Yo, if you're a fish...
Get out her swamp, honey.
Is Joe Flacco a gold jacket quarterback?
No.
He is her.
Dickity McFickerson.
You rat a weasel.
Is her?
The smile on this guy.
Freshly fixed.
Here comes Santa Claus. Here comes Santa...
Oh, that person's going nuts. Yep. They're fired up.
You know, actually simmer down a little bit.
Simmer.
Just go ahead and take a seat.
That was a really nice introduction.
I just look for a nice looking pair of white sneaks and I'm like, done.
It's the most spookiest time of the year. And with that being said, we're blasting off into the Good Vibes Galaxy because it's happy Halloween. Not known for my singing talents, but with that being said, ladies and gents, we are blasting off into the galaxy of good vibes in approximately 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Top of the morning, folks. Good afternoon and good evening, ladies and gents. Also, happy Halloween to you. Hope you're feeling extra spooky this spooky season. Ladies and gents, this Halloween, we have the privilege and pleasure of revisiting the second half of the spooky special, featuring phenomenal guests, starting first with my dearest cousin, Mr. Hunter Graham, Mr. Shane Brandes, and Mr. Samuel Hilliard in the building. Ladies and gentlemen, Spooky Season Special, Part 2, starts now. Farta. Welcome back, ladies and gents. We are happy to see you on a spooky evening. With the boys, and we're happy to have you here. And we're at a very special segment of the show, a first-time experience. And we are going to read, in the spirit of Halloween, some horror stories. You know, we're not scary movie guys, but we do it. We do it for the people, right? At the end of the day, everything we do, I feel like, we do it for the people.
For the people.
We do it for the people. We do it for the story. We do it. We do it for the.
For the.
For the boys.
For the boys.
Always for the boys.
So that being said, I'm just going to rip off the first one. So I'll just give a quick insight. I just searched short, scary stories. And this is what I got, ladies and gents. So stick with us. You're on the mission with us. Here we go. First one, titled, This New Old House. Here we go. Fire me up. We bought an old house. Oh, it's a girl telling the story. Okay, I'm going to try and switch it. We bought an old house, my girlfriend and I. She is in charge of the new construction, converting this kitchen into a master bedroom, for instance. While I'm on wallpaper... Oh, okay. Fuck. All right, fuck it. I'm just going to say it. I'm just going to read it how it is, because I'm messing the story up. It's a girl telling it, I feel like. We bought an old house, my boyfriend and I. He's in charge of new construction, converting the kitchen into the master bedroom, for instance, while I'm on the wallpaper removal duty. The previous owner papered every wall and ceiling. Removing it is brutal, but oddly satisfying. The best feeling is getting a long peel similar to your skin when you're peeling from a sunburn. I don't know about you, but I kind of make a game of peeling on the hunt for the longest piece before it rips. Under a corner section of paper in every room is a person's name and date. Curiosity got the best of me one night when I Googled one of the names and discovered the person was actually a missing person. The missing date matching the date under the wallpaper. The next day, I made a list of all the names and dates I found. Sure enough, each name was for a missing person.
I thought these were short.
Dates to match. Hey, we're almost done here, all right, Chief? We got two sentences. We notified the police, who naturally sent out a crime scene team. I overheard one tech man say, yep, it's human. Human, question mark. Removed from the walls already, question mark. This isn't wallpaper you were removing.
Ba-da-ba-ba. Oh, damn.
So she liked peeling her skin, so she started peeling the wallpapers because she liked it, and then she figured out it was not. It's other people's skin.
Ugh, disgusting.
On her wall?
I guess so. It doesn't have an explanation. Okay. Interesting. So,
what kind of house is that?
So, the next story is called I Hate It When My Brother Charlie Has to Go Away. Who wants to take this one?
I'll take it.
Okay. There it is. We got a second spooky wookie story coming right up. Ladies and gents, fire up. Get ready. Grab your pumpkin.
I hate it when my brother Charlie has to go away. My parents constantly try and explain to me how sick he is. That I'm lucky for having a brain where all the chemicals flow properly to their destinations like undammed rivers. When I complain about how bored I am with a little brother to play with, they try to make me feel bad by pointing out that his boredom likely far surpasses mine, considering he's confined to a dark room in an institution. I always beg for them to give him one last chance. Of course, they did it first. Charlie has been back home several times, each shorter in duration than the last. Every time without fail, it all starts again. The neighborhood cats with gouged out eyes showing up in his toy chest. My dad's razors found dropped on in the baby slide in the park across the street. Mom's shit. Vitamins replaced by bits of dishwasher tablets. My parents are hesitant now, using last chances sparingly. Ooh. They say his disorder makes him charming, makes it easy for him to fake normalcy, and to trick the doctors who care for him into thinking he's ready for rehabilitation. That I will just have to put up with my boredom if it means staying safe from him. I hate it when Charlie has to go away. It makes me have to pretend to be good until he is back. Whatever that means.
All right.
Wait,
let's give it up.
These stories aren't even scary.
Can we give it up?
We'll give it up.
No idea what that means.
Do you want a story?
I need some.
Should we do some Halloween jokes?
Halloween jokes.
Ooh. Halloween jokes for sure.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, these Halloween stories, you know, they're not like a Christmas story. A Christmas story makes you feel nice, warm, and fuzzy and happy. And these stories just make you feel shitty.
Especially because we don't understand them.
They make you... I feel like the first one kind of made sense. And, you know, years, you know.
Was it me?
Was in it to win it? No.
Can we have a vote?
No, it's just a shitty article.
Yeah.
Tough article. Tough, not tough. I mean,
Shane.
We didn't ride it. We were just, you know, having some fun. So, gentlemen, what type of jeans does a ghost wear?
What?
Any guesses?
Wranglers.
Spooky jeans.
Skinny jeans.
Bougies.
That's pretty good.
That's a good one.
I like that one.
Why did Dracula have no friends?
Why?
Because he wanted to suck their blood.
Because he was mouthy.
Because he was a pain in the neck.
Ooh,
that
wow.
Damn Dracula was a pain in the
damn
neck.
Damn it, Dracula.
I shouldn't do that one.
That guy's sketch.
Okay. Next Halloween joke.
Give us some more.
Brothers. What type of key is used to open a haunted house, brothers? Think hard.
Spooky.
A spooky.
Really?
Love to see
fire
it.
Fire me up, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's go.
What does a spooky look like?
You don't want to know.
Bro, I feel like it's one of those ones, you know, with the elaborate old school ends that has the long thing and just the...
Like the master key?
The greasy old keys. The old school ones. You know what I'm
talking about? Kind of like rust.
Am I making sense?
Yeah.
Smell what you're stepping in.
Yeah.
You smell it? Okay, y'all got any Halloween jokes? Just curious.
I really don't.
Brother Shane, I feel like you...
No?
No.
You're just going to fire one off.
I don't. I didn't up my joke game before this.
That's okay. That's okay. Not required on the Hamm Planet Podcast. I just like to be, you know, good guy. Make sure Ferda. Brothers, appreciate now we have an essential question to you two lads to my left. What is the best? Well, it's not for us, brother. Me and you don't know how to answer it, I feel like.
Okay.
We'll see. I mean,
go ahead.
You'll see. It makes sense. Senores, with an S.
See.
What whiskey or bourbon is the best number one in the world? It wins.
I believe Hunter and I will probably have the same answer.
Agreed. I'll let Sam take this one over.
We love the Weller Full Proof. Is that correct?
Absolutely.
The Blue Weller. Man, it just gives me chills every time I take a sip. Kind of like when people listen to the Spooky Special, how they get chills. It's kind of the same type of feeling. Yeah. Oh, man, it's so good. Full proof, hot. Full of flavor.
Hot. What does hot mean? Like you put it in the oven, it's, you know, put it in the microwave?
It's like a high proof bourbon to where it like it burns a little bit more.
It's like whenever it's really, really cold and you're taking a nice sip of like coffee or like a nice hot chocolate or something. And it's you're outside by a fire. You take a deep gulp. You feel that burn slowly going down your body. That's the burn.
Yeah. Perfect.
Gotta you know, it.
Brothers, I heard this one time. I'll give a shout out to who I heard it from. Uncle Beaver, a bourbon connoisseur. He told me if you feel the bourbon, go all the way down to the old sack. That's like, you know, it's good shit.
Agreed. But that just like...
Feel flow through the body.
And but also the thing with bourbon, though, is that it's all like different. You know, there can be some hot, like, bourbons that people love. But at the same time, someone who can love bourbon just as much as them, like the stuff that is lower proof. And the hotness is all inside the proof. So a 120 proof, it means the APV is 60. You know? Just hotter, you know? It's a preference thing. But Sam and I are on the realm of higher proof, nice and those like cherry bombs, nice and thick going down. And but other people like it not nice and soft, you know?
Yeah.
That's what she said.
Absolutely.
Yep. Yep. I'd agree there. I mean, I've seen people like all different types of things. In the whiskey and bourbon realm, of course. And Senor, my question was, is the spiciness consist of how much alcohol is in it? Or is it from, is it possible for it to be from like, you know, some, you know, black cayenne pepper in the barrel? Or could it be, is there other shit that contribute except the alcohol proof?
I would say it mostly consists of the alcohol content in the whiskey. The higher the alcohol content, the more it's going to feel like it burns. And that's what we mean whenever we say hot. But like there are
Is there other spices. Ones that can be, yeah.
Yeah, like when you say spicy, you know, like some whiskeys are made more with rye. And yep. They can be rye whiskeys instead of bourbon. And those, like rye kind of has like a spicy taste to it because rye is a spice. And you kind of get that spice note. And that's when you feel a little spiciness to it. Yep. But Senor and I, we prefer bourbon. And I prefer wheated bourbons.
Same. And it's a bourbon's made with like a mash bill. And
what is it? So normal people don't know what a mash bill is, Senor. Could you inform us? I don't know. It's speaking for myself.
It's just the ingredients that go into it. It's like the ingredient list.
Do you know what that is?
I don't know what that is.
Okay. I'm not just...
No, you're not alone.
Yeah. Like for the simplest things, it's exactly what Sam said. It's the ingredients that makes the beautiful juice. And one thing, one of the stipulations of being like a bourbon, 51% of the... of the mash bill has to be corn. But that's just one of them. But essentially, the easiest way to describe it is that with the taste and whatnot, it's all about the mash bill, essentially.
Mash bill, ladies and gents. Know your mash bills.
There's also another qualification.
Oh.
That
there's
has
multiple.
To pass. This is my favorite one. For it to be considered bourbon.
Same.
It has to be made in the United States for all those America fans out there watching.
Europe.
Go the same process, exact same ingredients.
Everything.
One step across the border in Mexico or Canada, not bourbon.
What is it?
Not bourbon. It's actually a law.
What is it? Whiskey at that point?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can't call it bourbon. If you call it bourbon, you're getting your ass beat.
Yeah. I don't know what would actually like happen because like there's like Japanese like whiskey too.
Bare knuckle
and Japanese
right now.
Whiskey yeah. is very, very good. But it's not bourbon.
Right.
You just can't legally like sell it as bourbon.
Yeah.
I thought okay. Japanese can make whiskey? I thought just
they make a damn good whiskey too.
Yeah, they do. Absolutely.
Are y'all sake guys at the end of the day? At the end of the day,
I do
can
like
you,
sake.
You drink a sake.
I can crush some sake.
Absolutely. Okay.
Sake
bombs.
Yeah.
Who doesn't like sake bombs?
It's
so fun. And doing the beating on the table?
Yes, absolutely. They are.
Ah.
One of the last dates
let's not beat on this
I was
table
on.
Oh,
drank
no, let's hear about
sake.
It.
Sake.
Is that your go-to?
Solid night.
Is that your go-to for...
No, definitely a margarita would definitely be one.
Margarita?
Yeah.
What about bowling?
Senor, no.
Bowling?
Bowling?
Bowling is, I like to go... I'm horrible.
That's a switch up for margarita, but yeah, I love bowling.
Yeah,
you can get a fucking margarita winner.
Who do you think you are? I am.
I hope everyone who's listening to this can at least once in their life witness Peter Hamm.
Can go bowling with me.
Bowling, because it's like a gorilla.
Peter Hamm playing
a small ball
and
holding
gorilla.
It on his forearm and just tossing it.
Peter Hamm doing anything outside of rugby. You should see it.
Yeah.
Being an apex, which is... The goal, I mean, you know, for most athletes.
Absolutely, agreed.
Is to reach the apex of gains and
Senor, do you feel like you're velocity? You're a apex?
Well, Senor, of course.
Like an apex predator?
I still have many, no, not predator.
Yeah.
Apex, alpha, you know what I'm saying.
When I say predator, not like the bad kind of predator, like a freaking
like from the alien.
Orca.
Orca.
Apex predator of the ocean.
Like a lion, a tiger,
yeah,
a bear.
Lion, tiger, bear. Yes, I'm in that category.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the category I'm aiming for.
Lion, tiger, bear.
Oh, Peter.
My. Peter.
Peter.
I think that rhymes.
I hope it does.
Rolls off the tongue.
Okay, so speaking of bears and tigers, I got to know. Senor Hunter Bear. Which I might just get with the answer. But what is your spirit animal? Is it a bear? Is it not a bear?
You know, the odds would probably be minus 1,000 a bear.
What are the odds?
And I would put a trillion dollars on bear because easily a bear. I'm built like a bear. I wake up, feel like a bear. Honey, best thing that you could possibly ever have.
Blueberries, salmon.
Yesterday, a bee flew on me and just stayed there because it felt safe.
You're one with nature.
Exactly.
Do bees standardly feel safe around bears? I feel like they're like, damn, dude, you're about to destroy my house.
I think bears...
bears are immune.
I think bears are god of bees. Are they not? Because they come and they destroy the entire...
I thought they'd be like the...
the colony. The
demon of bees.
That's true.
They'd be like the... did you ever... You played Age of Mythology Titans.
Sarah, me and you played
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we played each other a lot.
Yeah.
You know, remember...
I whooped your ass.
Well, senor, you had 7 months on me of mental curation.
Best 7 months ever.
Okay. But, fuck. Forgot where we were.
We were talking about bears. Spirit animals.
Spirit animals. Titan, I feel like, is the same as a bear to a bee because...
A titan?
Yeah.
A Nissan?
Well, the titan in this Asian mythology game. All my Asian mythology people, hit the like button, Ferda. And the old titan could destroy the whole town, right, Hunter?
Absolutely.
Okay, and basically a bear, what it can do to a bee is destroy its whole town, destroy its whole family, fucking eat its whole town.
And but in Greek mythology, the titans were the fathers of Zeus, like Poseidon and Hades, a.k.a. God.
Excellent point. Which that segues perfectly into my next question. Who is your favorite Greek god? Shane, we're going to start with you.
you started with the wrong guy for okay. the Greek god talk.
Brother Samuel, we're going to start with you on this one.
Well, I mean, I think everyone's like first classic answer would be Zeus. But
is that that's what the mainstream media is
doing? I mean, don't get me wrong. He probably is the best. But just for the sake of this, I'll switch it up. I'm a Poseidon fan, man, because I feel like every time I'm out on the water in the salt water fishing, Poseidon blesses my journey because I always come away with a freaking cooler full of fish,
and a pocket full of sand,
and a pocket full of sand, and then a belly full of fish tacos, baby. You heard me?
Yeah, I heard you, baby.
Shout out Uncle Mike.
Shout out Uncle Mike. Oh,
yes, sir.
Shout out Uncle Mike, a beautiful, great man, and a great
Uncle
host.
Uncle Mike. You should get him on the podcast.
That'd be so funny.
That'd be hilarious.
He's just a complete savage.
You think he's up right now?
Trout master.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That would have to be put on the dark web, though.
Would it? Okay.
You get canceled if he was on here for sure.
Yep.
Well, we don't do that here. I mean, no canceling. We're good vibes. We don't want to cancel
anyone. Good vibes
anyone.
Only.
No,
we don't want to cancel anyone. We absolutely do not want to do that.
Canceling.
Let everyone chase their passion.
The sage canceling out the bad spirits.
Amen.
Right. It deleted it. Killed it.
Yeah.
Every bad spirit just got dusted.
Washed away.
Smell you later.
Dirt dog downright dusted. Men. Next question of the evening. Start with Brother Shane. Shane, what's your prediction for the Dallas Cowboys regular season record?
Wow.
Curious, brother. Been needing to ask you this.
Well, they look good so far. Division's bad. My team included is bad.
Don't be a negative Nancy.
Shane, can you let the audience know who your team is?
The Washington Redskins football team.
Whoa, if you know Shane, no. As a legend,
is that,
you know that.
Like hyphenated?
Jesus, man.
It's Redskins football team for short, but we had the Washington on. sometimes.
Watch episode 20 if you want to learn about Shane's Washington Redskins fandom.
Ferda. Boys look good, man. I still think we're going to beat y'all twice, for sure.
When do you wake up?
Okay.
But
stirring the pot over there. That's all he's doing.
Yeah, I mean, outside of that, who knows what happens, but we'll probably beat y'all twice.
I need a number. Quick handily. Number on the record.
The Cowboys record?
It doesn't mean anything. No money, no anything.
What are they? They're what, 5-1 right now?
Yeah, 5-1.
5-12.
See, Shane, I get it.
Disrespect.
Okay. 5-12 is the final prediction.
Okay.
Who are we going to like lose to?
Everybody else on the schedule.
Well,
wow. Classic salty Shane.
Bucks?
100 to win 100 grand?
Ooh.
I'll do it.
Those are the best odds.
You should take that,
Peter. Honestly, yes.
No, actually, I'm good. We'll talk about that after the pod.
Cowboys ain't going 5-12, brother. We get it. We got, you know, love the Cowboys,
there's
you hate
17
them.
Games now.
There is. And I have no good words for the Cowboys. I wish them health, but bad things.
Well, I would ask a question like that.
Oh, damn.
The Skins, brother.
12-5 is 17.
It's.
Gig them.
You know, tough year.
Ha.
Okay, senor. So, what? Real quick, you know, we're 5-1 right now. What do we think the Cowboys are doing this year? Record, regular season record. I don't want to get into the playoffs yet. I don't like talking about that shit till we're there. Oh, either.
Which one of us?
Senor Hunter. Hunter. What's your
prediction? I personally think the boys can go 14-3, you know? I think that's like a reasonable.
I think that's very reasonable.
Yeah, we get 14-3. Yeah, that's 17.
I'll bet on that.
I'm like throwing out maybe Dak is hurt for like a week and we like lose like a game. You know, like this week is going to be very important going up to the Vikings. I think Dak is going to be playing. If he is, we're going to stomp him. -1, easiest bet you could possibly have. Put your house on it. But besides that, like the Kansas City Chiefs, they're are going to get like better in my opinion. We play the Cardinals week 15.
L.
I would love it's at
no,
home.
No, not an L.
I would love we're for us ass. To be like fighting for who's going to have the home field like advantage. And I think that game, I give it to the boys because it's home. I think Kyler Murray and that team is monsters, and they definitely can win.
Well,
but it's
stacked.
All about. It's all about circumstance.
Like
and if the circumstance is that we play them at home, we're able to win, we are the number one seed, and we are at home the entire time, I think that
team.
Gary Graham is going to buy myself and my brother Garrett Graham Super Bowl tickets. And it's going to be amazing. It's not a request.
Oh,
Santa Claus already sent.
Well, the Super Bowl bet. I have the same one with Sandy.
Gotta love Cowboys fans.
Love to see it.
I love them.
Bro, it's been my Christmas wish every year of my life is, Mom, I want Super Bowl tickets. But only if the Cowboys go. Okay, and I've been alive 20, just turned 27. I'm still a young stallion.
And but like, let's like
but
think about it, 27
years
though.
Of my life. Haven't got them. This is the year, baby.
Exactly.
We're going all the way. Dak, CD, Randy Gregory. I mean, the guy looks like Hulk. He's just ripping people's heads off.
And D-Law isn't even in the picture yet.
Yeah. You love to see it.
You love to see it.
You love to see it.
Boys. Boys, Bills.
Shane. Boys, Bills. Boys, Bills. Boys, Bills. Thoughts?
Nah, I'll go Bucks, Bills. Or Rams, Bills. One of those two.
Okay. Okay, moving on from the NFL chat. Now getting into some deep philosophical, mind-expanding, solar-expanding, universally, astronautically expanding our cerebral head. Brother Sam.
It's expanding.
Would you go on a 10-year mission in space if it was to go check out the planet that they think is just like Earth?
No. Well, I'd first like to point out my head is already expanding because
yes.
I have a huge head.
That is facts.
Well, and second of all,
yes.
To answer your question, absolutely not. I like Earth a lot. There's a lot of crazy messed up people on here, but
a lot of good.
My little pocket of this earth with my friends and my house and everything, it's pretty dang sweet. So I'm just gonna stay here.
Yeah,
I love it, Sydney.
Amen.
I mean, that's a valiant answer.
Space is sketch too, man. I mean, like, you can't even light a fire out there. I'm not gonna eat astronaut food. Like, what is that?
Imagine though.
It's Dippin' Dots.
That's anti-gains.
So
anti-gains.
We're 27. You come back. 27. I was just trying to shoot high to get everyone.
We're all 27 here.
We're all 27. Damn.
Great year.
In our prime, boys. We're just entering our prime.
We're just now.
Scraping the surface.
I think my
hitting that skyrocket.
My testosterone's the lowest it's ever been. It's about to be just outrageous.
Wait, it's the lowest it's ever been. So yeah.
Lowest it's ever been.
Yeah.
Let's get it.
Low T, brother.
Yeah, low T clinic.
Peanut butter going. Calling. Let's get you fired up.
It's gonna get like higher.
You know,
yeah.
We're gonna blast that shit to the moon. Well, now I'm thinking about peanut butter sandwiches. Because of testosterone, you know, peanut butter is one of the best natural foods you can eat to amp your test.
Yeah,
no lie, bro. I shit you not.
What about? I hear oysters are pretty good.
They're okay, but who's fucking eating oysters?
Me.
I love oysters.
I'll eat them, but it's not like I can go take a scoop of oysters, you know, at 3 a.m. when I'm trying to get huge.
Depends.
I actually just got back from Washington, and I went and picked my own oysters. Out of the ocean.
Okay, that's badass.
And ate them, and they were about as big as this bottle. Like, they were humongous, slimy bastards. And I love oysters, and they're probably a little too big. Like,
wait. Show us with a hand image. What like, the?
How can our listeners?
It's not an oyster. Dude, our listeners need to get on YouTube. It's a slimy sucker, show, ladies and gents.
It was like, you know, you usually can swallow an oyster.
Look at
you
the
suck
size of this oyster. If and you're listening on Spotify, get on YouTube right now. Look at the size of this oyster. Can one more demonstration?
I mean,
for
you had
the
to
coming over?
Slurp these and chew these some bitches, like multiple chews. It was pretty gross. It's
bigger than a tarantula.
And I like oysters, man. But yeah, good for the old libido.
Absolutely.
Do you guys have that
libido?
Yeah.
I don't know. I've heard it on it like a.
It's a men's
commercial
with
Frank Thomas.
Yeah.
Eugenics commercial.
Oh, he's Frank Thomas, dude.
Yeah.
He's got high T.
High T.
So they weren't oysters. They were some sort of...
No, they were oysters, brother.
There's no way. I've never seen a tarantula-sized oyster, have you?
I have.
You have?
The fresh ones. The freshest of fresh. No, like, stored ship stuff is gigantic. Almost gross. A little too much.
You can eat more peanut butter than you can oysters. Most of the time.
No.
Unless you've got racks where you're just like...
That's true.
Oysters.
Oysters are expensive nowadays, man. My dad told me that when he was young and he would go down to Galveston, Texas, he was getting oysters for like 10 cents an oyster. Nowadays, you go somewhere, you're lucky to get them for less than $2. Thanks, Joe Biden.
Let's go, Brandon.
Honestly...
hate to see it.
A dozen costs $25.99 at a nice place. You know,
Sam, you could probably eat what, 4 dozen? You think easy? 48 of them?
Easily, I could eat 100. I guarantee it.
I also could too.
I would love to see that. How do we make?
Honestly,
that
oysters
happen?
Are good shit. Some people hate them.
I don't know. I mean, we're gonna have to bring our checkbooks out. Yeah. But I'm down. That sounds delightful.
How about this? We buy them. I'll make them.
Make them.
And we'll see if Sam can eat 100.
I'm down. That'll have you ever tried to shuck an oyster, by the way?
Would that be a great video, ladies and gents? Let us know in the comments below. Do you want to see Brother Sam Hilliard?
Hamm Planet Clips.
I have a yard. I have a nice yard. We can boil them up.
No, but raw. I want them raw.
Raw.
Okay. Yeah.
We just need to throw together the checkbook.
Having them cooked, that's a different challenge.
Yeah,
definitely. You need them raw. That's.
Yeah. I just think they taste better raw.
I honestly like them raw
as
well. Yeah. Do you like them raw?
Me?
Love them raw. Hunter.
Senor.
Absolutely. Yeah. Like, are they my go-to food? I'm more of like a steak and potatoes.
Same.
Like a hamburger, french fries, that type of guy. But yeah, absolutely. I'll go ham.
Senor, how many burgers do you eat on a weekly basis?
You know, probably about one every 2 weeks. So a half.
Bullshit.
No, it's true.
Senor, that's very good.
Senor,
I'm
focused on the fitness gains.
I understand.
You know.
Me too.
Yeah.
Me too, but you know.
But like a grub, like burger.
I'm doing better.
There will not be a better one. Definitely would say go.
Grub?
Grub.
If we're getting one burger right now, who do we call?
Grub. And
Grub Burger.
Grub Burger.
Grub Burger.
In Dallas.
Grub Burger in Dallas.
Who are you calling SBZ?
Yeah, who you calling, huh?
I'm a burger guy. I don't discriminate any burgers, top to bottom.
Well, you got to have a favorite.
Give me a Big Mac. Give me a... I love Five Guys. Five Guys burgers are up there.
Five Guys Fox.
I thought you were going to say In-N-Out for sure.
Well, I love it. I mean, same. If we're saying fast food burger, listen, I'm Texan. Love Whataburger. Shout out Whataburger. Love In-N-Out burger, though.
What's the best? What do you say? Which one?
I mean, give me In-N-Out fast food. I apologize, but give me In-N-Out
over
fast
Whataburger?
Food. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Simple.
Are you shitting me?
The spicy ketchup is elite.
Sam, so did you invite him or did Petey?
I don't know how he got in here.
Hey, man. Hey, cut this shit.
Y'all take it easy. Take it easy.
This guy is from Texas.
I prefer Whataburger over In-N-Out overall.
From DFW.
Wait, so you say In-N-Out's where you're going?
Not a Cowboys fan.
Well,
hates Whataburger.
Hey. Playing in the good
What's
vibes,
next?
Damn it.
Definitely don't hate Whataburger. That's fake news. Whataburger is just a place where I need the ketchup for the burger to be elite. You know, it's here, ketchup, elite.
So you're taking
In-N-Out is kind of just.
You're taking In-N-Out over Five Guys? Would you say that?
No. Five Guys is a quality burger. And the fries are just so much better, the Cajun fries. Ferta.
I've played baseball with a lot of Californians throughout the years, and I've had this In-N-Out Whataburger argument many times, more times than I could even count.
Yeah.
And I will concede to the Californians, the In-N-Out has a better hamburger.
Thank you. That's exactly
what
I'm trying
to say. That's what we're asking.
But which Whataburger's menu is extensive.
So much better.
You can get breakfast. You can get a chicken strip sandwich. You can get a patty melt. I mean, like...
In-N-Out's just plain Jane. You know what you're getting. Yeah. You can get whatever there. Yeah. Whataburger menu, elite. Overall, so elite.
So, like, I think it's just better overall. I mean, that's...
You asked me what my favorite burger was.
Yeah, I'm not arguing with you.
Okay, so we got In-N-Out. We got...
His hands are E for everyone.
We had... What was our vote for both of you?
Whataburger.
Whataburger?
Whataburger.
Whataburger's number one above, like...
I know I just
Smash
said...
Burger.
I know I just
am,
said...
Am I talking... Out? Are we talking... Is that too slow?
I think I'm only at Smashburger like once.
Smashburger's like a fast casual.
It doesn't count.
We're talking about like fast food.
Okay.
There's not many places I like go sit
Y'all
down
know me. Y'all know
and
me.
Get a burger.
I like Sonic.
You know what I'm saying?
Senor, you love
You're a
Sonic.
Guy.
Bro, I mean...
I think you
Sonic
you,
has everything.
You get the cheesy chili tots every single time.
No, I don't.
Peter eats.
I used to
Sonic hamburgers for breakfast.
Yeah,
no,
I know.
No. Men. I'm not in that phase anymore. I went through it.
Okay,
it was hard.
So you did.
Did we stop last week?
Honestly, we stopped. Shit, it's been about 8 months. So I went through like I'll be honest. You know, if you're listening, honesty is the key in life. I went through a 3 month phase where I was slamming the cheeseburger and wings every morning, just being a fat bitch.
So I bet you were a happy fat bitch, though.
I want to have a gym in my future podcast studio. If someone, you know, wants to bang out a few raps, Ferda. I want to have a whiskey shelf with a sliding ladder.
Boy.
With a sliding ladder. Hear me out, Senor. I want a life-size NASA sculpture. I know, not sculpture, but
like standing man.
Yeah, and I know where to get it. From Rocket Fizz in Arlington, Texas. They got one right outside of their shop.
What's Rocket Fizz?
It's a store. It's a candy, and it's an old school 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s comedy, funny shit.
Can you buy like neon lights?
Maybe. You sure?
I want to buy like that PlayStation thing. I want to get one of those, but like for Shiner or like beer for my memorabilia room.
Senor, you're talking to the right guy.
Hey guys, remember the time when I said 8:15?
Your furnace ending, brother. Hard.
Honestly, this is the earliest the Hamm Planet podcast has ever begun. And, you know, if we do end before 11, it'd be the earliest one had ended.
Well, first for everything, brother.
Well, I know. We're far from both of those time whistles. Or not whistles. No fucking whistles here, huh?
No.
Oh, we were talking about that the other night. Wouldn't it be great to just have a yellow NFL referee flag and a whistle?
Just a toss.
Just at any time.
That was on Saturday. That would be nice. Yeah.
Just when somebody does something you don't like, you just throw it.
Yep. Violation.
I think like a challenge flag. Like whenever like a girl is like, nah, you're like,
throw the challenge.
Redemption.
Yeah.
The whistle too is key.
This is the sign in baseball. If you want to replay, you go like this.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it, ladies and gents. You heard it here first. Do it. Just Am I doing it right? Or I'm looking.
It doesn't have to be perfect.
I'm not good at baseball signals.
And then if you don't want to do a replay, you just go like this.
Replay of what?
A replay, like a close play. The umpires will give the other team like a little window of time to decide whether or not they want to replay it or not. And if you don't want to do it, you just go like that.
That's it.
You go like this.
Like replay what? Like the
like if there's a close play that a team might want to replay.
Oh, and like the other team saying, like, "I want you to like double check it."
Yeah, like if there's a close play that didn't go your way, you can replay and get the call changed. Now it's one of the newer rules in baseball.
Yeah.
So. Okay, ladies and gents, welcome back.
That's not Chick-fil-A. That's like a Burger King. Is that Arby's?
In-N-Out.
Maybe. I haven't eaten In-N-Out, Burger King, or Arby's.
Yeah, the whole Chick-fil-A.
Thank you very much.
Chick-fil-A's up there, brother.
Okay. Well, I don't know what he's got his greasy paws on. Ladies and gents, welcome back to the good old Hamm Planet Podcast. We're happy to see you. We got this age going.
Got this age going.
We're not going to be throwing because we don't want to break shit. But we're happy to have you here on this spooktastic evening. Spooky-tastic. Fantastic. Smells marvelous. Good. And we're at the legendary Tradition Hamm Planet Podcast Would You Rather segment. And the question that we're going to start with is, if you are guaranteed not to get hurt, would you rather be stuck in a pit of snakes or a pit of spiders?
Snakes.
Snakes easily. Like the whole like the spider thing, you could just like feel all their legs or sticks or whatever those things are.
They're small crawling enough all over you. To get into all the crevices.
Yeah, spiders. Spiders are, I mean, greasy.
Yeah.
That's the word I would use to describe spiders for sure.
Greasy.
Same. Very greasy specimen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, second question. Spooky season special, baby. Would you rather be haunted by a ghost or be a ghost?
Be a ghost.
Easily be a ghost.
For sure. Yeah, I agree. Be a ghost.
Every day.
Be a ghost is a consensus. Do you agree? Do you not agree? Let us know. Next question. Would you rather be chased by Freddy Krueger, Jason Voorhees, who's the ski guy, ski mask guy, Michael Myers, or Ghostface, who's the scream guy, is Ghostface? I'd rather be scream chased guy. By him. Scream guy's a pussy, dude.
Yeah. I feel like I could just turn like around and just pop them.
None of them have like superpowers, you know? They're all on legs.
Freddy Krueger does.
What is he? Can he like teleport?
He kills you in your dreams.
That's right.
Yeah. See, like I'm not. It's hell no.
So, yeah, dude, definitely not him.
I'm going to the Scream guy. The Scream guy's like, in comedies.
Yeah.
This guy'd be easy to die.
I would just scare like.
Imagine seeing his dumbass face in your house and you're just like, what is this guy doing? You know, and he comes out with a knife.
I'll pull out like a gun.
Yeah, you're just like, it's over. It's a wrap.
Yeah.
All you have to do is put three in his chest, and then he's gone, right? The other guys, like, don't die.
He'd be
dust
after
you shoot, so.
May take a clip.
Well, anyways. That was an easy one.
a lot of shade. Good vibes only, I thought. Anyways, next one.
Welcome to the galaxy of good vibes, ladies and gentlemen. Next question of the spoopy special. Would you rathers? Brothers, would you rather be a werewolf or vampire?
Werewolf.
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 Werewolf is a consensus. Do you agree? Do you not agree? Let us know. Ferda.
Just not trying to, like, suck on people, you know? No weirdness to that, but
yeah,
that's what a vampire is.
If you're a werewolf, do you, like, you turn into a werewolf whenever it's a full moon, right? And the rest of the time you're...
Yeah, you got...
Or do you get to control it?
Yeah,
you know what I'm
like,
saying?
I feel like the whole...
Or does it just happen,
the control part, you know?
Yeah. Werewolf has, like, insane athletic ability and
yeah,
all that. That'd be so much more...
But I don't think you're able to really control what you do when you're a
werewolf. Can you not...
But that's, like, a mind thing.
You think you can harness that ability?
100%.
The werewolf thing's, like, when you're laying 100%. There and it just starts happening, right?
Yeah.
It's like
it looks painful.
Some whole, yeah, it does.
Kind of like a boner?
Exactly like a boner. Big, big blood rush also down to the painful midsection.
Yeah. Yep. Yep, 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 yep.
Trust a witch.
No, that's you, like, can't trust a witch.
Scientific facts.
Would you rather
trust the science?
Be attacked by crows or bats?
Crows.
We already got attacked by bats.
what are the number? What kind of numbers are we looking at?
We're still dealing with the scars.
Yeah,
like, are we talking about,
bro,
like, 50?
Everything outside the question's up for interpretation.
Okay.
It's a rule.
Bats. They're smaller. Depends on what kind of bat. Give me the small bats. I could smack them.
How many could you take out before going, like, hey, this is my max. This is how many I can
do. Do I just,
like,
have fist?
I could get, you know, 217.
Fist only?
Scissor hands.
Is that what you do?
Like, so I got some blades attached?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be interesting.
I could kill
to discuss.
I could kill
what would be your
bit.
Strategy of being, you know, flocked?
Scissor hands.
Flocked. Is that what it's called? Flocked?
Just swarmed.
Swarmed. Swarmed is, yeah, a vernacular.
Yeah. I don't know, man. That's
scissor hands. That's what you do?
I'll probably go straight for
scissor hands.
Yeah.
I feel like I could get a good 50 down. I'd get
50.
I'd get injured
before you get corona.
Yeah, probably.
If I had a katana, I think I'm
okay.
I'm coming out there just like,
okay,
fine.
How many with the katana?
In like a suit.
As many, like, unlimited, infinite.
I'm not gonna be touched.
Infinite, not even touched.
Yeah. If you could pick one weapon to protect yourself with, though, out of all the weapons in that situation, what would it be?
An Iron Man suit.
Yeah.
Is that a weapon?
Next question.
Ready to
of
go.
The Hamm Planet Podcast. Would you rathers? Señor, would you rather spend an entire night in a coffin underground or spend the night in a haunted house?
Haunted house.
See?
Same.
Easily.
Even though they're... the coffin on the ground, it's been done. It's been done. You got Mr. Beast on YouTube. He does.
Haunted house has been done, too.
Yeah. Who's to say this ain't a haunted house?
You do it every night, brother.
Honestly, it's not haunted. I hate haunted, so I get all that shit out of there.
If it was,
that's what the sage is for.
It's not anymore.
Exactly.
Yeah, as long as I got one sage, whatever they're called.
Sage.
I think it works great, honestly.
What are these?
Sage.
Okay.
This looks like a bunch of marijuana cigarettes rolled up.
Sage.
But it's not, though. That's the thing. It's a Native American tradition to enrich the soul and to, you know, be gone evil spirits. That's what it is.
I'm on that.
It's a legal herb, even in Texas, believe it or not.
Absolutely.
I don't think you can smoke it. I don't think you can.
Probably not a good idea.
It's only one way to find out.
Patreon 2030. Okay. Last question, best question. Ferdison. Brothers, spooky special. Getting real spooky. Would you rather finally fucking A, here we go. Would you rather be cursed to live forever or die young?
Die young.
die young? Because, like, in my die head, young. Like, a curse is bad. You know, like, wake up tough. Every day and, like, tough. You fall down on your face. I don't know. Like, that would suck.
Right. You
every
don't want to
single
get
day.
I agree.
Don't yeah. get cursed to live forever at, like, prime age, like I'm just 25 forever or something, or
that's a good curse.
Everything outside the question, up for interpretation.
Well, die,
rather die young, then
you get to go to heaven.
That is true.
That sounds
I know
better.
That's so kind of twinkle. You know,
if you live forever, you're I mean, this world doesn't feel like it's getting any better.
That
I mean,
is true.
Kind of amen.
So, no, it's getting better. The best is yet to come, but we don't want to live forever. I don't know, yeah. at least I don't.
Agreed.
Furter.
Big heaven guy.
Oh, big heaven. I'm hyped.
Furter for
great.
That.
God bless you. God bless America. And God bless the spooky special. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, senors and furter men, we've had a hell of a night. Is that fair to say?
Absolutely.
Sir.
A good travel through the galaxy of good vibes. Hell of a night. And you love to see it.
Love to see it.
Love to see
and
it.
And ladies and gentlemen, if you've stuck with us on this mighty fine, spooky special evening, make sure to do your brothers and your boys a further favor and share this podcast with anyone who needs some good vibes. We love you. Have a wonderful night and stay spooky.